Let's now talk to House Minority Leader Bienvenido Abante, who was among more than 200 lawmakers who signed a manifesto supporting Cayetano's leadership. Good morning, Congressman Abante, and thank you very much for joining us, sir.
Good morning, Christian. Good morning to all of you.
So what's it going to be? Will Speaker Cayetano stay on, or will the term-sharing agreement be upheld and that he would be replaced by Congressman Velasco?
Well, there's a lot of words that have been said already, so I will just have to wait for the Speaker's message on it. As we have said in our manifesto, we in the minority will abide in the decision of the majority on the matter. If I may quote, we said we recognize that the choice of House speakership rightfully belongs to our esteemed colleagues in the majority. And as tradition dictates, it is the majority that chooses the Speaker of the House. In this exercise, the minority is a mere passive observer in this process. So we are deeply committed to submitting to the wisdom and respecting the will of the majority.
That's true. But why did you sign the manifesto in support of Congressman Cayetano in the first place?
Well, we did because we feel that in this pandemic, there are two things, no? Pandemic and the budget deliberation. We do not want to rock the boat in the middle of the ocean. So we feel that if there's any change of leadership right now, it would not be appropriate. So Speaker Alan Peter did a good job as Speaker. And siguro tapusin na muna yung budget deliberation. Pagkatapos ng budget deliberation, then let's go to the political intramurals. And that is what we're trying to say.
But would a change in leadership in the House of Representatives actually affect the minority?
It might. It might. And we are, you know, I'm prepared for it. It might. We just don't know. But of course, the minority bloc is one and united to, support me if that ever happens. So I really don't know, Christian. I mean, I'm prepared for an eventuality anyway.
But have you gotten word on what would actually happen, let's say on October 14? You're just not at liberty to disclose it.
Well, I really do not know, Christian. There are some statements being said by both sides. And at this point in time, it would be very premature of me to comment on that now. So I really would like to hear the statement coming from both sides anyway. But and if indeed the president would really insist on term sharing, I think that the speaker would be honest enough to, give the cudgel to Lord Alan Velasco.
But as minority leader, how do you imagine working with Congressman Velasco as speaker? Because you already expressed your support for Congressman Cayetano.
I don't think there'll be any problem. Lord Alan is also a good congressman, a good man, and it's a kind man also. So I think that we could be able to really work fine with him. Although, as I've said, Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano is more experienced in handling this situation. So we feel that in this pandemic lang naman, in this budget deliberation lang naman, wag muna natin galawin yung leadership. Pagkatapos yan, then let's talk about it.
But what happens to the issue of word of honor, for example, which was also cited by Congressman Velasco? Because, of course, you were not able to, who could have anticipated that there would be a pandemic at this point when the term sharing deal was brokered last year? But even then, you knew for a fact, and many other congressmen knew for a fact, that the timing would be at this time, that the change in leadership based on that agreement would happen. Actually this week,
yes,
actually today.
That's true, Christian. In fact, nung pinag-usapan naman yung term sharing, wala pang pandemic. So this came in, you know, and therefore, kung napunta itong pandemic with the budget deliberation, I would think that it would be prudent for us not to change leadership at this time. And I think that even Lord Alan would understand that. In fact, hindi naman ibig sabihin that there will be no change of leadership. Ang sa amin lang, the minority, is that you do not try to change something that would affect the budget deliberation.
Now, how, again, I asked this already, but I'd like to get more details. For example, we are familiar with the composition of the minority bloc in the House of Representatives, but assuming that there's a leadership change, are you expecting, for example, certain members to join the majority, or in fact, your number might even increase? You might attract more members coming from the majority.
Well, I'm expecting that we're going to lose some, but also I'm expecting that we're going to attract some members of the majority to join us in the minority.
Now, when you signed that manifesto of support for Congressman Cayetano, weren't you concerned that that might somehow cement the impression that you were actually handpicked by the speaker last year?
Do you want again, Christian? I didn't get the last word.
Because last year there was a suspicion that you were handpicked by Speaker Cayetano to head the minority. But now, a few days ago, you signed this manifesto of support in favor of the speaker to stay on. Wouldn't that somehow cement that accusation, that impression that you were handpicked indeed by the speaker? That you were his guy?
That would depend on what they would think. No? I think that we have done our job well. And I think that we in the minority has shown that we can make adjustments and we can work with majority and we can stay in the minority and do what we should do as minority as a minority in the House. See, so it will depend on the other side what they would think about us. To me, I am prepared to go back as a regular member of the of Congress or whatever it is at stake for me.
Okay. Now, we were showing pictures of the president meeting with Congressman Cayetano and Congressman Velasco. Actually, you're seeing images of that meeting last night now. How do you feel about the president intervening and, in fact, openly stepping in to settle this leadership row at the House of Representatives when, in fact, at least on paper, we have the so-called separation of powers between two co-equal branches of government?
Well, that is not surprising, Christian. That has happened before, and I think it happened to all administrations. As I've been saying, that the only time that Congress would not be independent is in the choice of the speakership, because in every administration, the president wields a lot of influence over the speakership. But the purpose of speakership, we do our work independently with the executive.
Yeah, that's true. That it's very hard to disengage the president or any sitting president from the choice of speaker at the House of Representatives. But is that
right?
Is that right?
What's that again, Christian?
Is that the right thing to do? I mean, we have the so-called separation of powers. You're talking about the reality, the practice over the past several administrations. But is it right?
Seemingly, Christian, if we will really have to really do what the Constitution says, the executive should let Congress be the one to make a choice. But in reality, Christian, that is not actually happening. So I have to accept the fact that when it comes to the speakership, the president will always wield great influence. But I also be comforted that after the speakership role has been resolved, Congress will continue on being independent. And I feel in the minority that we have been very much independent of the executive as far as the separation of powers is concerned.
Okay, of course you're speaking for the minority bloc, but can you honestly tell the public, our viewers now, that beyond this choice for speaker, that Congress or the House of Representatives as a whole is actually independent of Malacañang?
Well, you know,
given the actuations over the past few months, for example, can you honestly tell that to the public?
You've got to remember that Congress is composed of several parties. And many of the congressmen belong to the party of the president. Many of the congressmen has actually supported the president. Alam mo, ganun din naman sa US eh. I mean, with a two-party system the US has, the Republicans and the Democrats, no? And when the Republicans win over the Democrats in Congress, who do you think becomes the speaker? Of course, the speaker becomes a supporter of the president. In the same case in the Philippines, where we cannot deny the fact that whoever is a sitting president, his choice of speakership will follow, you see. That is reality that cannot be avoided anymore, Christian.
But shouldn't we work to fix that reality? Or are you okay with that?
Well, I might not be okay with that, Christian, but still, realities, harsh realities are realities. And I'm only one congressman in Congress. We have about 300, and I cannot actually speak for and in behalf of the other congressman who would vote according to their own conscience.
Okay, let's go to some legislative priorities by the current Congress.
Yes.
Of course, now is the budget season, but Congressman Cayetano yesterday announced that the House of Representatives would look into allegations or the actions of Facebook regarding certain pages and accounts that were taken down. I remember, correct me if I'm wrong, that you once headed the Committee on Public Information. Is that correct?
Yes, I did.
In a previous Congress. So what do you think about this? Should this be a priority by the House of Representatives to actually look into this?
Well, I would like to speak for the minority. Ang focus talaga namin dito, Christian, is a 2021 budget. We really would like to help craft a budget that will help the country respond to the pandemic and bounce back from the economic aftershock of the virus, no? So sa amin, sa akin personally, well, unahin muna natin yung budget. Tapos saka natin pag-usapan yung inquiry na ganito. I don't think we have enough time for that because October 17, end of session na yan. So we have to spend time. There's still a lot of departments that should be tackled, no? And I don't think we have very little time. Spare time to be able to conduct an inquiry on this matter.
Okay. Now, as a final point, the minority bloc stood quite strongly in its position against this PCOO undersecretary who had been red baiting members of the Makabayan bloc at the House of Representatives. But I think the response was that she would tender her irrevocable resignation only if the members of the Makabayan bloc would condemn the atrocities coming, let's say, from the New People's Army. What do you think of this? And how strongly will the minority bloc stand on this particular position in the context of the budget deliberations for that particular office?
Actually, we have deferred the budget of the PCOO until Yusek Badoy issues an unconditional apology. And when we speak of the term unconditional apology, to be honest, it's redundant, no? An apology is an apology if it comes with strings attached. If you are sorry, you say sorry, pero hindi mo sinasabi, sorry, pero itong gawin nyo. The setting of conditions in our view just shows that she is insincere regarding her apology. A hollow apology is nothing but empty words. I mean, it's not appropriate for a high government official to say that to any sitting congressman. She's got to remember that we are elected officials, and to be able to accuse members of the House of being terrorists is an issue that involves the whole House, not just our colleagues from the Makabayan bloc. And I believe it would be inappropriate, unbecoming of a government official, particularly someone who works in an official communication under the government, to accuse House members of crimes without proof. O, sinabi ko mga sa kanya, kung meron kayong mga ebidensya, and you're really putting it, why would you go to the court of public opinion and convict some of the House members by publicity? I mean, go to court against them. go to court against them. So sa amin, you accuse a member of the House to be a terrorist. It is just like accusing House members of being thieves or being corrupt without evidence. Hindi naman kami papayag na gawin niya ng mga katapat namin sa Executive Department.
Okay. House Minority Leader Bienvenido Abante, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.